higher price at the bottom of the pyramid so the people at the top of the pyramid can sell it and make money from them. That, to me, that doesn't seem like a good thing, but we're going to ignore that and not act like every single crypto is a scam so we can talk about today's drama, which is about Logan Paul and, of course, his cryptocurrency that he made, CryptoZoo. He's the majority owner in it, and it was exposed a couple weeks ago by CopyZilla to be an alleged scam in a three-part docuseries. Now, you can go check that out, but we are talking today about the update, which is Logan Paul's response to CopyZilla. Now, before we jump into the actual video, I think it's important to read this tweet from Logan Paul, which says, "While I generally appreciate Steven," that's CopyZilla, they're close like that, "and his creative genius and exceptional work ethic," I mean that, "this one is simply not true." All right, wow, he really likes him. Creative genius and exceptional work ethic. Let's take a look at the video.
To morph from an investigator to a gossip channel. You see, CopyZilla tried to work with law enforcement in the past, but his work was described as not anchored to truth and often speculative. He is a lopsided journalist with an agenda, and he's nothing more than the Keemstar of crypto and finance. But...
okay, wow, we went from creative genius to the Keemstar of crypto and finance, which, if you haven't picked up on yet, is an ad hominem attack, a logical fallacy, so that instead of arguing the actual points like, "Hey Logan, I think the crypto you made is kind of a scam," he's able to say, "No, the person who's arguing against me is a cringe idiot, so none of it matters, and I don't have to argue it," which happens a lot in this video and was wildly disappointing. Now, it is worth noting that this isn't Logan's first rodeo. He doesn't really bring it up in his video at all, but he's done a little bit of crypto scamming before, specifically with an NFT called Dink Doink that he was a part of, and I'm going to show you just 5 seconds.
I'm holding his GoCos.
I'm going to show you, but watch.
And drugs.
For sure.
Oh! You ready, Dink Doink? Let's do this!
I'm gonna pause this now. Oh, and I got a sword. Interesting.
Man has come to an end.
Interesting. I feel like I want to roll. I legitimately want to roll. Like, I there's no way I play Electric Charge, I feel like. Electric Charge would be good on Bruisers, but am I really playing Bruisers? Isn't everybody just gonna hard force it?
The magic calls to me.
Oh, look at these items, man. I should just frontline my Vokas. What the fuck? What am I playing? I won't push level because there's some 3-cost and 4-cost I really want to get. And maybe it would kind of sway me on what I'm playing. Because I think everybody's going to contest Jax, and I'm trying to go for the first. Fucking a top four to hit masters. I'm trying to get a first place. Well, I won. Oh, tank Vokas did not do shit for me, huh? Who would have thought?
Vi stands for vicious.
No, I'm pretty sure I'm playing AD now. But it's like could be just Giant Slayer, and I could get some AP items. I mean, I hold any if I, hold any no matter what, huh? No, I hold Malphite, maybe. Alright, I can take a little Knights, or Zeke's Herald, I mean. It's not too bad. Okay, this guy's team is not bad, and he has Throw the Hunt, so he might actually win this. Oh, we took the first unit though. That's actually pretty huge. Gotta be pretty even. Nah, we lost. He has Rageblade. Yeah, rip. And he didn't even get the kill on Gossip. Interesting. Maybe we just full open now. Lost two. Cause do we even really spike? In like this stage? Cause sometimes I wanna lose 3-1-2, or I can just full open. That's five. Is this really me full opening, man? I might actually beat this guy on accident. Oh, thanks for the raid of five people, Cryptid. How are you? How's your stream? I know you were playing some Dead by Daylight earlier. If anybody watching, go follow the most amazing person ever. I like how the new shadow in chat, they kind of added that, I feel like. You put a link of someone's Twitch. I feel like I used to have a shadow clip. Oh, it didn't. It's not on. What the fuck? Wait, let me get this item first. Oh, bow's not on. Am I getting glove? Yeah. Probably get glove. I might not play Jax. And I already have swords, so there's no reason for me to get another sword. What do I want to do with my econ? On Vi. Make some gold. We better hit masters. We're so fucking close. I mean, I have a last whisper, which is honestly very, very important if you play AD. Pretty much any AD comp kind of not requires last whisper, but definitely the best item in a last in a. Well, it's a very, very important item if you play AD. If you play AP, Shiv and Ionic Spark are also very important support items that you'd be trolling not to slam if possible. Okay, this guy broke my loss streak. What the fuck? I tried to sack and I still won. Yeah, I need to pay more attention to these shitters, man. Dude, I really want to make some econ. I mean, I could just go. I can. It's fine. What's everybody playing? Maybe a Kai'Sa? Potential Kai'Sa? The guy's rerolling Yuumi? That guy, I think, is definitely playing Kai'Sa. This guy's playing Jax for sure. Rageblade Jax. His team's a little sus. I don't know what's going on with his team. But. Okay, that guy's playing some form of AP. Another AP comp. And then this guy. He's definitely playing some AD comp, not Jax. He might be playing Kai'Sa, or is he rerunning Ashe? Probably not. So you could. I mean, he might be playing not Kai'Sa. Samira or. My guess is Samira or Zed, but it's probably Samira, to be honest. Am I just holding everything? I feel like I hold nothing. I feel like I beat this for sure. Like, I'm strong enough. If I get gold, I make 40. I'm pretty sure I get gold. Started the game with 4 components. That's actually... Or I started the game with 3 components. What am I saying? And I got this with the carousel. Like, this Blitz is tanky enough to at least tank 2 Krugs for a while, while these guys beat up this Krug. Oh, I got a Rod? Interesting. We're just gonna Econ up. We're pretty healthy, actually. 80 health. I would've preferred a 5 loss streak, though. Oh, I didn't get any gold. What the fuck? Or Jax?
You're in bite range.
What is going on? What am I playing? JG Jax is not something I like. I feel like I just don't play Jax this game. I mean, if I get another bow from Carousel, I feel like it's not even that bad. I just hit an early Jax. It's gonna make me like kind of stabilize. Even if I lose this, like I lose by, there's no way I actually win this, right? It's actually no way. It's a good loss. See, if I would have lost that one round, you know how much gold I would have? Like, it's actually like a 7 to 10 gold difference. What are these options, man? It's just disgusting. All right. My mind is made up. I'm playing Jax. It's really JG. Am I really? JG is not my favorite thing. I can always like pivot to be honest, out of this. Alright, I'm getting bow off Carousel here. Oh, look at all these Jaxes that's gone. Alright, I kill more units if I have my Jax on the left side than on the right side. Like, he actually killed maybe 2 units. Maybe 3. Oh no, this Vi's kind of tanky. And he has a ZZ Rot. Come on, kill one unit, please. Oh my god. I killed one. One unit. Bruh, I don't even feel good transitioning like Aesol here, man. I'm pretty sure I just play Jax. Go 7, roll down the fuck 0. Get a 5th, you get the fuck out. Maybe even a 4th. If I can get a 4th and just hit Masters. Cause like, what is this guy playing, man? Is he really contesting Jax? Like, what the fuck? From that spot with IE Rageblade? He just hits a random Jax too? Like, how unlucky, man. It's good, man. IE con up. I'll hit. Trust. Oh, wait. Do I win this? Huh? Who did have Soraka? Nah, it's close though. One unit loss. Fuck it, I guess I'm winning. No way I win this. No way. I won this, huh? Renekton, dude, a fucking challenger Renekton on my team. Do I even want to win that? I don't know. There's no bows. Oh no, there's no bows. I need a cloak. There's no bows. I repeat, there's no bows. Oh my god, I needed a bow so bad. There's no way. Ah, that's so unlucky. I gotta think about this. I mean, I slam BT no matter what. Oh, I hit another Jax. Do I ever slam Shroud? Double Shroud. Shroud is such a good item. I shrouded 4 people. Not bad. I shattered the whole team, actually. I'm insane. There's no way I win this because I hit Shroud, right? I mean, there's a chance. Oh, no. This guy's too strong. Dude, this guy just randomly hit Jax, too. I actually killed myself. I'm trying to figure out what his late game is, though. Or is that his late game? Is this stronger or not? It just does not feel stronger. The Shroud. Honestly, I don't care if I win this, man. Like, honestly, I think I'm down to just try to save as much health as possible. I would like to honestly lose, have like some type of streak. I actually won this. I heal up. Oh, nice. I'll take this win. I'm not mad at it. Honestly, it's worth. I'm gonna hold any pair just because. Oh, nice. Who am I missing, man? A Riven? Man, I don't play Zed. I'm pretty sure I stick with Brawlers. Like, honestly, if I hit 2-star Jax and I hit a bow right now, I'm pretty sure I'm just, like, super stable. I don't even know what my admin is. Bow? The bow?
I will not die.
Bow? I guess I could have done Rage Blade, huh? Fucked up. To serve the greater good. Why'd I combine that? I'm trolling. Time to make an appearance. This could be Shojin. Nah, I agree for RFC, man. Cause there's still a good chance I can hit it. And if not, I'll get Rage Buddy later. Like, who cares? Oh, Brawler Crest. GG. I just go to 8 now. Huge, man. That at least in. 2-star Lee Sin. I need 2-star Jax, that's fine. I go to 8 because 8 Brawler is just way too strong for me not to go for. Honestly. Swapped the last second again. Got him. Fucking nerd. Try me again. I'm pretty sure this guy's pissed weak. What the fuck are these? What is he playing, man? His team is just JG Sona. Does he have heart? No heart. So I just insta win. Holy shit. It's Tillet, man. Like, playing Jax, honestly, this game is kind of sus. Especially that I didn't hit both in the last carousel. But, honestly, I'm in such a good spot. Like, I'm still super stable. And even though late game, I might get fucked. To be honest. I mean, honestly, I hit Brawler Crest. It's honestly not that bad. If I have a really good admin, It might actually be GG. Like, if my... Because I'm pretty sure I play Soraka. Like, I don't... Well, I don't have to play Soraka, but... If you don't play Soraka... Because, honestly, the admin definitely matters. Like, you don't play Soraka unless the admin is, like, actually decent. Just the other guy... He still has Jax 2, man. So, like... There's no hitting Jax 3 this game. Did he flop? No, he kept us inside. I mean, I lose to this no matter what. This guy's Omega strong. I mean, maybe Sona like pops off right here. Chances Sona pops off. Nah, she's dead. This guy is pretty strong. He's gonna play a Aurelion Soul Carry. That's usually what that's what I was thinking about too. Aurelion Soul is really good in this comp because it's a threat. You don't care about the synergies. I mean, there's a bow right there. Oh, it's too lit. It's too fucking lit. Let's go. I greeted, and it was actually the right call to greet. Because if anything, I can get a rod. You know. And then, I mean, Tyr and Rod got taken, so I really needed Bow, because that was the only thing I really needed. It was Rod, Bow, and Tyr. Everything else, honestly, like, tank items in a Brawler comp is not that good. Like, the only person is really, like, Sedge that you care about. I'm down a level and roll. Like, just, it's a top 4 move here. Give me one Sedge. Oh, Jax, too. I'll take it. Take a Leona, I guess. Or just Jax. I'm not playing Sona for very long. I'll literally play anything over Sona right now. I don't really care about True Heart. Alright, we're super stable, man. Alright, I didn't hit Sejuani, but honestly, this is not even that bad. At least I hit Jax 2 and Leona. That's not that bad. I'm going to keep rolling, though, because I kind of want to hit. I mean, do I just play Sona over... Nah, because I have nobody even throw in, so it doesn't even matter. Really, your soul is better, right? Dragon's breath it is. I mean, is it Leona or is it Fairy Soul? That's a good question. That is a great question. I'm pretty sure it's Aesol, man. Like, he does more damage than Leona. Leona is gonna kill one unit and die. Ooh, this guy is super strong. Did we beat him? Oh, Leona popping off on the right side. Let's go. She killed two units? It's too lit. The reason you never really go offensive items on Leona, though, is because she does essentially true damage. And she ults until they die. So it's like, there's not really much reason to put damage on them, because if she ults a unit, like, that unit will die. However, it takes her a long time to... It doesn't say how long, but it takes her about, like, 3 seconds or 2 seconds to... Oh. Actually, like... I'll show you. Look how long... You guys can count. Like, it takes a minute. But this unit's pretty cool, man. Like, she ults, and, like, that unit... So, I think that if you guys ever play Leona, the best items you really can do is healing items. That way, she won't die during her ult. Oh, I got tier. Nice. Fuck it. Another tier? Oh, no problem. I mean, there's no other items I can make, so we're just a handy dandy tier. Oh, Sedge. It's two. Shucks. Alright, what is it? Oh, attack speed? Oh, that's worth. That's actually pretty good. Oh, I missed the Jax. What am I doing? Why did I miss that Jax? I mean, it doesn't even matter. I can never play Jax 3. Dude, what is this guy's team, man? Shojin? All one stars? No frontline? Huh? Is this? I feel like it's getting a master's is way too easy, man. It honestly is. I think people are just getting more and more confused this set. And like, this is like such a good time to climb if you know like what's strong. And like how to top four. Because everybody plays like, I don't know. I'm not trying to talk shit to be honest. But like, I can just tell a lot of people don't get it. Oh, just hit. Did I make 10 so Jax? Who's that the Jax players? It's a Jax player. Not bad. This guy sold his Jax. Okay, I'm not gonna sell. Okay, I win this time. He only had RC Rage Blade. There's no way I lose this. He's gonna go to Vi, not my Jax. Oh, never mind. Rip, my Jax is dead. He's still not targeting the Jax. It's fine, my whole team's alive still. No way we lose. Nice. I mean, when he dies, I roll down for Jax 3. So I just save up gold here. Oh shit, never mind. Jax 3 is already on his way. This is the Jax 3 that this guy sold. I just got it in my shop. I'm actually 3 ahead of this guy now. But I mean, he has 6 Aurelion souls. What the fuck? Dude, what is this double redemption shit? Isn't that kind of nuts? Got him. Dude, this guy is worse in slot positioning. And I'm pretty sure I'm almost best in slot. Does this... I don't think this reaches still, though. Oh, it will now. Oh, best in slot. Let's go, man. Huge. Oh, this Urgot's about to ult my whole team, though. He's about to get hella money. Oh, we only got one chest. Okay, can we just appreciate that I just am hitting masters? Holy shit. Like, dude, it's honestly been a long time since I've been masters. Like, I'm low-key a fraud. Last set, I hit masters in set 7, and I never played again. That's not true. I still played TFT, but I literally did not care about last set. I hit masters, and I was like, I'm done. I'm not playing this shitty game again. And then 7.5, I think I went like diamond one, and I was like, I low-key tried to hit masters at the very last week of the set, and I couldn't do it. Oh my god, I'm one away. Do I roll? I'll wait for this guy to die, and I will, for sure. Just to guarantee it. I don't want to waste all my gold. Am I playing against this guy, or that guy? Like I just played him. Alright, I'm not too mad about this positioning. It could be worse, to be honest. I should have kept my Jax more towards the middle. But I was trying to kill the Yumi player. Alright, we're chilling. He's not getting targeted. We're chilling. This guy's dead. I don't know what the fuck just happened, to be honest. His frontline is non-existent. His frontline... What is his frontline? Oh, it's 2 stars. 2-star Rambus, 2-star Cho. Oh, that's like... Oh my god. Hit... Wait, this could probably be a first. Oh, it's too late. I contested Jax and I won. Dude, honestly, that you guys, if you're even remotely in a Jax position, and you don't know how to, you're gonna top four, you just play Jax. Like one Bo and one Jax, and you literally just play Jax. To be honest, like there's just no question about it. Oh, this guy is in worst slot positioning for me. I'm in best in slot. He's in worst in slot. Where's that other, like this guy, he played a bad, like he didn't even really have a good spot for Jax and he still went fifth. Like you played bad, you probably still fifth. Oh, that's literally a 3-star diff. Like I lose this if I am 2-starred. Alright. Dude, my Renekton never dies, man. This unit's a fucking, he's a straight unit, like a legit unit. Fuck it, 3-star Riven. I mean, is there anything for me at 9? Honestly, not really. I think the best thing I can play is probably, what is the best thing? Urgot, maybe? Probably. I don't even need Urgot, really. Oh yeah, Urgot would probably be pretty good, actually. A good position Urgot is way better than Aphelios. Or should I roll down for Soraka too? What am I playing here? Holy shit. Look at these Vi items. I mean, it's probably just like Redemption, I assume. Like, I don't care if it's easy, right? He backlined his Yumi. And he kept it backline? He didn't move it up? What the fuck? This guy not scouting. Look how fast my Jax is already. Oh, he has, he's eating my Jax. And he's not healing. Oh, he's no longer targeting. Oh, that's a huge win. I mean, I just level for Urgot now. Fuck the Soraka too. I sack two more. I'm at 40. I have 44 on health. So I can sack two more. I sack this one. I sack next round. I level up. Hit Soraka 2. Hit Urgot 2. Alright, boys. Top 3. We're back in Masters, man. Dude, the way I've been playing, I feel like I can hit like GM quick. I'm just going to Zephyr middle because I don't want to try to guess where he's going to go. Honestly, not even bad. Zephyr the Phileas. Also, Zephyr to Sejuani. Or not Zephyr. I keep saying Zephyr Shroud. I mean, Shrouding the Sejuani doesn't even matter if he still casts. But does that ever prevent a second cast? Probably not. Oh my god. I need Soraka too. I just go 9. It's fine. It's a win out. I mean, I can't die. Like, it's impossible for me to die right now. So there's no reason for me to level. There's no way I died like from using these two. So I always level since I'm pretty much as strong as I'm gonna be. And then I roll down for Urgot. I already hit my carry like 2-starred everybody except Soraka, but Soraka is like not the main carry. Nice. I predicted that he's going to put his Yumi on the right side. So he's always going to target like the left side up here. Oh my god. He kind of went through my team pretty fast. This guy dead? What am I looking here? Nah, what am I looking for? What am I looking for? The shroud? Nope. Actually, give me another redemption. Now, I guess I can redemption two sides. So everybody hits a redemption instead of putting on one person.
I am the robot. Hear me roar. Roar.
Wait, no, I don't want it.
This is my path.
This is my team. Oh, we're still pretty good position. Honestly, maybe I want Jax furthest away. I think it kind of does the same thing. We just gotta get through this Malphite. I'm dead. Wait, kill one more? Oh, wow. That's a second? No problem? Oh, man. Holy shit, we did it, boys. We actually did it. It's a one out.
Never stop, I'll get it if I want it. Gotta make to myself a promise. I won't quit, keep going till I got it. I won't give up till I'm on top.
Yo, no, I ain't the type to give up. If I do something, man, I do it till I get what I want. I turn a business out of nothing into something I love. I got a poker face, but honestly, I'm not one to bluff. I flip a switch, never miss, man, I always stay up. Don't let them see you, bitch, always have a plan to stay tough. This life ahead of you ain't easy, it was built to be rough. But that's what makes a personality is tragedy, bruh. So keep your head on your shoulders. Now we ain't out here moving rocks, we out here moving boulders. Now we ain't getting post.
Tell you what you guys should be playing, man. I'm gonna tell you what to grab and what not to grab. If you're ever playing AD, or always grab bruisers and mascots. They're both pretty good. Poppy and Wukong are usually pretty bad, man. I mean, there's very specific scenarios where you can try to play defenders, but overall, defenders is pretty bad, man. I mean, Buckler on Poppy is pretty good, but the Wukong argument is somewhat good if you want to play Wukong carry, but in general, it's pretty bad. So if you don't have any direction on frontline, you either play two bruisers. If you get a bow, just force Jax. You want RFC, but if you don't, Rage Belly BT and like QSS or any damage item is pretty good. If you get like Rod and Glove, you usually want to save that for Soraka, to be honest, or any like backline unit that's AP. So it's usually Soraka or Aurelion Soul. Those are usually the only really teams you can play. I mean, there's a world in which you can play Talia, but I mean, usually you just want to play Aurelion Soul. Play Blue Buff or Shojin. Two AP items, you're chilling. If you get Brawler's Crown or Brawler's Heart, you just go straight to level 8 and get 8 Brawlers. If you don't have a Brawler Crown and you're not contested, then you reroll at 7. If you are ever contested or you have or you can possibly go 8 Brawler, then just go to level 8 and then roll. You can roll down to level 6 or level 7 for 2-star Jax, but just be careful when you do that. A lot of times you don't need to. Because Jax stabilizes really hard, so honestly, there's not really a reason. If you're being contested Jax and you have like Jax pair, then go ahead and roll on 6, but honestly, you probably don't even need to. A lot of times I would just roll on 7 for Jax 2 and then go 8. Just because Jax 1 is still pretty strong, man. There's no reason for you to just take one more Jax out of the pool than the other team just because you want to hit before him. It doesn't really change the game that much. And all you do is just ruin your econ. And if you have Brawler Heart or anything like that, just go straight 8. Jax is really, really strong. You want a healing item and like as much bows as possible. For the admins, if you get attack speed or any gaining maximum HP per round, like your team gain maximum HP, like those type of admins, you want to play admin. If you don't get either of those two, Like, you don't really care about the stacking AP ones, to be honest. They're okay. And if you natural Strock or two, you can play it. But if you don't get a really good admin, just play, like, Aurelion Soul or something. I'm trying to think of anything else but Aurelion Soul you can play. I mean, there's a world you play Leona. You can play Fiddlesticks. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, you can also play Sona, to be honest. Like, you can 3-star Sona and 3-star Jax. So I've actually done that before, too. Which, if you don't like the admin, Sona 3 is really, really strong with the same items. It's probably stronger than... if you could 3-star it, it's stronger than Soraka. Because it'll actually heal up your team and stun them. So it's actually pretty good. You just... Again, still blue buff. And that's Jax, man. It's really the easiest comp in the game. You can also play Tearstart. And Tearstart is actually really, really strong, or Tear Rod. But Tearstart, there's also the Yumi reroll that everybody knows about. There's also Lulu reroll. So I'm not going to talk about Yumi reroll. But a lot of times, if you ever contested reroll, whether it's supers or anything, like one cost rerolls, and people are going to grab the same units. Where is the other one cost that I'm looking for? Nasus. I already have Nasus in. Okay, so yeah. So there's also the Lulu reroll comp that I'd like to tell you real quick. So let's say there's a Yumi player in your lobby, but no one's rerolling Lulu, and you don't really even need the Lulu augment, to be honest. Any lightweight's pretty good. Blue battery's really, really good. And Drew Lotus is really, really good. And Blue Battery and Drew Lotus is good for any AP comp, to be honest. But it's good in this one. But you don't even need, like, any augments to play Lulu reroll. You just if you can, you try to get as much gold as possible. Don't ever level up, like, never push levels. You just get as much gold as possible, hit 50 gold. Once you're at level 4 with like 8 out of 10 XP, if you're contested, you want to roll down pretty much all that gold, or maybe down to like 20. You can kind of fill it out if you're hitting a good amount, but all you care about is 3-starring Lulu, 3-star Nasus, and 3-star Galio. If you hit 2-stars like Malphite and Lee Sin, obviously this is what your board looks like at or in the Gangplank. You can 3-star Gangplank too. I forgot about Gangplank. But you don't really care about the 2 cost. But at level 6, this is your board, right? So you can hold Malphites and Lee Sins. But when you're rerolling at level 4, like, you can sell these units to make room for these units if you like run out of space. Obviously Think Fast and High Roller is good. Think Fast, I think, is a little better. High Roller is not as good. But if you ever get Think Fast or High Roller, then, like, just reroll for these units. These units, you don't even care about 3-star if you play Lulu reroll. It can be stronger than Yumi sometimes. Because you can just push levels. So once you 3-star all these units, sometimes you can, like, a lot of times I just 3-star 3 units. But if you can 3-star all 4, that's pretty good. I mean, if you're being contested, sometimes it's kind of hard. If you're not being contested, then just slow roll at level 5 with 50 gold. And only go down under 50 gold if you start losing too much health. Like, if you get under 40 health, then you can start rerolling down to, like, 30 gold. But you should be able to hit pretty fast, to be honest, because you're only rerolling for these 4 units. And then these units, all you care about is just at least 2-star in them. And like I said, even if you lose supers early, it doesn't matter. You're just 3-starring these guys. And then once you push to 6, you can start putting them in. That being said, usually, yeah. And you just push levels. Once you 3-star Lulu and, like, at least 2 of these 1-cost units, you just push to 8. So you end up putting in Yumi, then you put in Sona, and then you put in Soraka. And then if you get a heart crest or whatever, then you can put in Syndra for 6 heart. And then this is pretty much your team. You can also play Nunu somewhere in here too. So it won't let me go more than 9. Okay. Is this Sona or Senna? Am I tripping? That was Senna. So here's like 6 heart, or you can take out sometimes I take out Soraka, or you can take out Sona. It just kind of depends. If you kind of, you don't really need damage, so a lot of times you don't even need Sona. And then you can play Syndra with Nunu. This is a lot stronger if you get the Heart Crest. You can play this comp too. Heart Crest, Mascot Crest, You don't necessarily need six heart, to be honest. Four is actually pretty good enough. So you can play this. And I mean, if you end up not three starring one of these one calls, and you can take that out, or you can take out Sona. Yumi's pretty good, to be honest. But if you take out Yumi, you can have pretty clean synergies and play like another, like Mordekaiser, Zelina, any of these legendaries, to be honest. Janna's probably the best, to be honest. But yeah, this is like the Exodia comp late game for Lulu reroll. And then Lulu reroll is pretty much the same items at Yumi. I mean, you just want blue buff. JG is really, really good. You don't never slam Rabadons on, never play Rabadons in any of these comps because it's not worth. And then you can slam Shiv, you can slam Gunblade. Any third item doesn't really matter. Like, I wouldn't slam like Rabadons or Archangel because you already actually have enough AP. You're just doing damage items. So it could be Giant Slayer is good, Gunblade, Shiv, and then you definitely want like Ironix or Shiv somewhere in this comp as well. And then Locket's always pretty good early game if you get a lot of rods. So you can lock it your three cost unit, whichever one is three costs, you can, because if you look at the description, if they're three, wherever's three starred, you can get 400 shield. So it's pretty good. And then you can just shield your team. And then if you're playing against Yumi, just try to put Lulu like in the middle somewhere. That way she doesn't get hit. You can even put like right next to her and like she can shoot through units. But for the most part, just make sure you position well against Lulu, because she will die pretty fast. So just make sure she's not in the way of like Talia or Yumi or anything like that. And then you guys already know the Yumi comp, so I don't need to know about that. But this is pretty good. And then blue buff, like, let's say you don't, like, you're not in a good reroll position, like, you can literally play 3-star Sona blue buff, you can play 3-star Zoe with blue buff, you can play Soraka carry blue buff. Like, there's so much options with blue buff. Yumi carry blue buff. Like, a lot of units use blue buff. So, you pretty much just, if you play Sona carry or Soraka carry, you can go 4 heart or 4 Spellslinger. It really doesn't matter. And if you play 4 Spellslinger, you can play Talia as your secondary carry. Just make sure you have a good balance between tank items and frontline items whenever you play AP. When you play AP, you really need good tank items unless you play, like, supers, which... these gloves is just probably your best bet for these units. But like if you play Talia carry or something like that, having a really strong front line is pretty good. If you guys play Talia carry, just be careful. It's if you hit, you're really strong. If you don't, you just brought forward really hard. It's one of those comps that you can stabilize pretty hard in level 7, but level 8 is how you actually top 4. So I think you guys already know the Talia comp, but you can also play Soraka if you don't hit Talia. Soraka is always a good secondary carry. And then for frontline, like, it's always the same, man. Like, don't. You can hit this late or you can hit this early. It actually does not matter. But it's always going to be Annie and it's always going to be Echo. Like, that's all that matters. As long as you have these two units. 9 times out of 10, I also always play, like, LSR 2. So that's my whole frontline. And then everything else, all you care about is having at least 3-star Guardian. So you can play, like, I think Yumi is often a unit that you can play. And, like, you pretty much just play around that. 4 Spellslinger is best in slot. So you play, like, Sona and, like, another Spellslinger. You play LeBlanc, and then once you hit Janna, you put in Janna. So this is pretty much what the strongest team you can probably play. If you have Star Guardian Heart, you can take out, you can put in Syndra, play 5-star Guardian. It's pretty strong. You also don't have to play Yumi. You can also play Syndra, like I said. What is the other good one that I'm kind of blanking out? I mean, Nyla is okay. I think it's usually just Yumi, to be honest. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's just always Yumi. I don't honestly remember... Oh, you can also play Lux for 6 Spellslinger as well. So it's either Yumi or Lux usually. But most of the times you don't play Lux unless you know you can hit 6 Spellslinger. But like this frontline, like once you 2-star this frontline, like you don't need to worry about frontline. Echo, like the difference between Echo 2 and Echo 1 is huge too. So just make sure you have like good tank items, man. Like Warmong's Declaw is like your best bet always. And then Gargo is always really good too, because yeah, a lot of time you solo frontline them and you can play like that. Same thing, just tank items. I wouldn't put tank items on Alistar, even though he scales with health, as much health as possible. Like, these are your true frontline units that you need. And then, like, blue buff is important. JG, Giant Slayer, is my, what I recommend. This is probably best in slot, what you're looking for. You can also go blue buff Sona as well. You don't give a fuck about Lux. You can throw it around to the side. If it's the shield one, then you just bunch everybody up. The best one is Windy, when it gives you more attack power. That's the best one. You can put a Echo. Echo scales with it as well if you get building AP, because it gives a fat shield. So you can play like that. If you play against Zed players or any hacker players, you want to bunch up like that. And then sometimes you want to put Talia there. If they're middle, this is best in slot, but a lot of times it really doesn't matter. You can kind of do that. Put the Alistar all the way in the back. And then if Sona 2-star, or whichever one is 2-star, because they have more health, you want to put it next to Talia in case they're on the middle, because they may not chase this. This might go up, and they might not chase it and go straight to whoever's next to Talia. And just make sure this person has, like, a lot of health. If they die really fast, then Talia won't be able to cast two times. But once she casts twice, like, the Zed or whatever just dies. Also, having this is pretty good. You can also, a lot of times I don't play Soraka if I'm able to hit another really good unit, like Sejuani is not really that good, but anybody with CC is good. So like Urgot I play often, so and take out Talia, and then you can put in like Leona or Nunu. It's pretty good. Syndra also fits in here for, I don't even think I have 3-star Guardian, so yeah. So this is pretty good. You can take out Alistar for Leona if you ever get like a 2-star Leona. And then this is pretty much the Exodia comp. You probably never lose in this spot. 4 Spellslinger or 6 Spellslinger if you're able to get 6. If you don't have Spellslinger heart, you never go for 6. But yeah, this is pretty much like the Exodia comp, because Syndra CCs, Sona CCs, Echo taunts, Janna CCs, Urgot CCs. It's pretty good. You can also like flex in Aphelios if you can, over Leona, so you can have just even more CC. Having as much CC as possible is like kind of the goal, because you only have, a lot of times you only have like 1, maybe 2 frontline units. This is just super late game, so if you're able to 2-star this, like a lot of times you just win. It's really, really strong. I'm pretty sure that's pretty much all the comps I play. Like, that's really only thing I play. Like I say, if you go 2-star, there's a lot of blue buff holders. That's all really strong. You can get first with every blue buff unit. Zoe, Sona. Sona is probably better. Is a lot better than Zoe. So if you have a Sona angle, I'll probably don't grief your econ to stable too hard. But the thing about AP, though, is that you're going to lose health, man. So you can't be too afraid. You got to know when to kind of roll on 7. You never roll on 6 ever playing AP. Like, just don't do it. Don't ever roll on 6. Don't roll on 5. You only roll on 7 sometimes, and you really want to roll on 8 for all your 2-stars. And try not to tunnel Talia too much if you're playing this comp. Even if you have, like, Spellslinger or Star Guardian Heart, if you don't hit 2-star Talia, you will lose. So, maybe focus on any 3-star Sonas, 2-star Soraka, Aesol, just in case you need a top 4. Because you will lose pretty hard if you don't hit 2-star Talia and no 2-star frontline, so... That being said, that's my guide to climb high into TFT, man. Hope you guys kind of enjoy that information. Anybody listening? That being said, I am pivoting out of TFT. I did it.